Welcome back to KidsLearnPianoLive.com. My name is Jamin, and as you can tell from the countdown clock here, the lesson is about to begin. If this is your first time playing piano, welcome. I'm very excited for you. You're going to do great. Hopefully you already received from us the welcome packet in the mail, and maybe you even got started on the Absolute Beginners video pack to teach you the names and the notes and things like that. But if not, that's fine, you'll do great. I'll show you how to play all the notes. And if I'm going too fast for you, you can always pause the video or rewind it and go over the more difficult parts. And even if you only learn a little bit of this song and you don't learn the whole thing, you'll still learn enough to help you build skills so you can learn other songs faster in the future. So jump in, give it a try. You're bound to end up at least a little bit better than you even are right now. Throughout the lesson, I may refer to Klopple Academy, and you can check out that link on the website if you want. Basically, it's a program that takes you all the way from like learning the names of the notes, the very beginning, through 12 levels of classical and jazz music, through all the skills that you would need to become a professional pianist. So you would learn all the same stuff that you would learn if you're taking regular traditional piano lessons, probably plus a little bit more, but it takes about 5 to 10 years to complete. So you can just try out the first level, see if it's the kind of thing that you like, or if you just care about today's lesson and learning this song, then just ignore all those references and focus on today's lesson. If you're watching this at learnpianolive.com, there should be a PDF and an MP3 button right next to this video. The MP3 is a play-along track that you can use to practice more after the lesson, but a lot of students like to print out the PDF right now so they have it during the lesson. Careful, it could be up to like 30 pages, so just find the couple pages that you want and print those out. If you decide not to, that's fine. I'll show you all of the notes on screen as we go through it. And we will be going through 5 different levels of this song that all use the same play-along track. So even if you've never played piano before, you'll still be able to do level 1. And then as we go through level 2, 3, 4, and 5, then when we use that same play-along track, you just keep playing your same version. If you're watching this lesson in the archives and you have a question during the lesson, then feel free to click on that survey button. And at the end of the survey, there's a place for you to ask your question, and I will do my best to get back to you with the answer to that question. But if you're with us live as we're recording this today, then feel free to click on that chat button and you can talk with all the other students who are logged in during the live lesson. And if you have a question about the lesson, then you can just go ahead and type that into the box that says, ask Jamin a question, and we will do our best to answer that question live in the lesson. All right, I think that's the end of the boring stuff. I'm ready to learn a song. Stay tuned at the end of the lesson and I'll show you how to win more points and earn more prizes next week. But for right now, let's get this party started. Welcome back to you. This is Pop Goes the Weasel. Welcome back to this guy. It's Jazzy James. And he's going to be learning the song right along with you for the first time. And this is our chat moderator, the incomparable Kendra.
Guess what? So I'm writing this book just for fun. And I just reached 50,000 words. And I'm really excited. That's like my halfway point.
I have no idea how many words. Yeah, how many pages is 50,000 words?
Like 80, and like I'm using Times New Roman size 11 font.
Yeah, I still don't. Like, okay, so if I go to buy this book at the store, how thick is the book?
It's probably, I don't know, like.
Is it Harry Potter or is it like?
No, well, it's like the manual for my blender. It'd probably be a little bit smaller than the smallest Harry Potter book, I'm guessing, because
okay.
I want it to be double the length it is right now.
Okay.
But
yeah. All right. Make the font size bigger.
Idea.
Oldest trick in the book. Wonderful. Well, tell us about our weekly activity.
This week is the songwriting dice, and this one is kind of tricky, probably mostly for the older students who have done the workshop at learnpianolive.com/songwriting. But all you have to do for the 150 bonus points is cut off the dice and put them together and tag Learn Piano Live when you post the picture on Facebook or Instagram.
Yeah, that's one of the most advanced ones, but that's also one of the most fun ones. So once you get to using that one, hey, clap. Oh, good to see you. All right, I get the message. You, get out of here. Go practice. You, have your PDF open. Let's check out this song. We got to watch out. This one is kind of fast, but it's pretty repetitive and it's short. So hopefully we'll be able to get a lot of the song in before Kloppel cuts us off, and we'll be able to maybe play through the whole thing, perhaps. It's going to start on a C. This is going to be the most important note on the piano. In order to find a C, you're going to take any group of two black notes. I'm probably going to take that group of two black notes right there. Take the note that's on the left and drag it down and land on a C. It'll be a C every single time. And we just play two of those. And then we move over one note and play two of those. And then we move over and we play one of those. So that's the beginning of it, is all around the mole. And you can play all of that with one finger if you wanted to. All around the mole. Now, it'd be nice if we could play two of the E's, but there's a note in the middle. So you are going to play two E's, as it says right there. But first, you're going to stick a G in the middle. So a G is just, if you play this note, that one that we landed on, if you skip over a note, that one right there is a G. So you're going to play an E and then an E, but in the middle, you're going to stick that G. E, G, E. So E, something in the middle, and then E again. So two C's, two D's, two E's, but with a G in the middle. And then play the first note that you played again, this one right here. And then we kind of do the whole thing all over again. This note right here, if this is your very first song ever, you might want to just cross that one out and play All Around the Mulberry Bush, Monkey Chase the Weasel. This G is going to be a tough one to throw in. But if you want to play it, it's going to be three notes below, to the left of, the note that we started on. It'll end up being a G, but you don't have to pay attention to the letters as long as you end up on this note right here. It's got, you're skipping over two notes in the middle. Right there. So it's going to be this note right here. That's the, if you want to play the. And then we're going to play two C's again, and then go up and play a D. And this one does not repeat the D. Instead, we're going to skip over, just like we did before. We skipped from an E to a G, like that. Now we're going to skip from a D to an F, and then play an E and a C. That might be the trickiest move of the whole thing, is this chunk right here. It's two skips. That's a skip up. D up to F, and this is a skip down, E down to C. Again, this note is optional, this G. You don't have to play that one. If we come down to this one, we're going to play pretty much the exact same thing that we did in the first line. That thing right there is Monkey Thought 'Twas all in Fun right there. That's the whole first line. Then we have Pop Goes the Weasel. That part that I said before, Chase the Weasel, is the same thing as Goes the Weasel. So that one little four-note phrase right there is going to be Chase the Weasel, and also going to be the last little section, Goes the Weasel. Before we play that, we got to throw in one A. This is probably the most important note of the whole entire song. It's going to be the one that's most noticeable if you leave it out. So we can't leave this note out. We're going to go, we've played a C and a D and an E and a G. We're going to go one note past the G, land on an A, and that's the one for pop. I know, I wish it was like one of the easier notes down in here, but it's going to be Pop Goes the Weasel. Okay, so then if we try this thing with the track, it goes pretty fast, but at least you can get the last note. Okay. Fine, this will be our last time through with the track. Don't worry, we're going to get to practice a lot on track 2, 3, 4, and 5. At least get the first note, it's a C, and at least get the last note, it's a C. If you just hang out on C, you'll get a lot of right notes. Here we go with the track so you can hear it. And a 2, and a 1, 2, 3, 4. All around the mulberry bush, the monkey chased the weasel. So I take it back. I said you should know at least just the C, but you should also probably try to pick up that A if you can as well. So they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like 6 notes apart from each other, the C and the A.
C, D, E, F, G, and the next note up would be A. So if you can get the pop goes the weasel, that would be a great place to start. But for right now, it's time for our feature of the day, which is Wedding Wars. We're going to need Kendra in for this one. I'm going to play you two notes. You're going to tell me if those two notes are the beginning of the song.
Should I turn off the keys?
No, not for right now. We can leave it on.
And should I like get the smaller thing? Or am I okay blocking the whole thing?
You're fine just like that. So our first song is the wedding song. And the other song, instead of the wedding song, would be this.
Ooh, I love this one.
Okay, cool. So then if you hear these two notes, that's the beginning of Star Wars. If you hear these two notes, that's the beginning of the wedding song. Or if you don't know, that's fine too. But I'm not going to play these ones right in here. I'll give you these ones here. So these two notes are the beginning of the wedding song or Star Wars.
Are you sure you don't want me to take the keys off?
No, leave them there for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure. Yeah.
Is that the beginning of the wedding song or Star Wars? What do you think, Kendra?
I'm going to go with the wedding song, I think.
It is the wedding song. Nice job. Way to go. Kendra wins all of these games.
Well, no,
it's
because I can see
does.
The... Cause oh, it goes
all
to the
right,
one
fine.
The,
take the keys off. Here we go.
That's what
the
I
tougher
was...
tougher version.
Wait a second.
That's all right. Take your time. Here's the next set.
Try.
So. Those ones right there. Is that the beginning of the wedding song or the beginning of Star Wars?
Is that okay?
Yeah, it's great.
Okay.
What do you think? Star Wars or the wedding song?
Star Wars?
Yeah. Cool. All right, so we'll do one more of these. Is this the wedding song or is it Star Wars? What do you think? Guessing at home. Kendra, what do you say?
I'm going to go with the wedding song.
It is indeed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So those were perfect fourths. The wedding song is a perfect fourth. And Star Wars is a perfect fifth. And if you're in Clapple Academy level, I think 4, you're already starting to do this stuff where you have to pay attention to the size of the intervals and stuff. If not, it's just a fun game we play every now and then. Let's level up.
Transitioning to level 2. This may be confusing to level 1 students, so please continue to practice the level 1 version or visit learnpianolive.com/level2 for a detailed explanation on how to level up.
So sadly, the lesson preview has come to an end, and it's time to say goodbye to everyone watching the free streams. Of course, paying subscribers at learnpianolive.com can continue watching this lesson and several hundred others like it in the archives. So come on over and check us out, and if you like what you saw, at least like and subscribe, and then tell your friends to head on over to learnpianolive.com to start enjoying this journey with us.